Okay, good morning everyone. So in this particular session, we'll be discussing about the remaining portion of your M2M, what we have discussed, the first part of your second unit. So basically, today we'll be discussing about something called software defined networking. Okay, so previously we discussed about CNA, right? So I'll just flash some light over it. Anyhow, in the previous session we discussed, just small brief introduction related to that. So CNA is nothing but what we have already discussed here. So this is the architecture related to your CNA, okay, conventional network architecture. Now here we said that this is the traditional kind of architecture which is used in order to send the information between different devices. So basically here this has been developed using something called as specialized hardware, as we already stated, something like we have routers and switches using which it has been actually constructed. Now here we have something called as data plane and control plane here. If you talk about data plane in this particular scenario, this is the one which is actually required for transmitting the packets. What are the packet size should be, okay, how much should be the packet size, what it should consist of, that payload, all information will be taken care by data plane. Apart from that, we also have something called as control plane. So what is the main purpose of this control plane is routing the packets. So from which route the packets have to, whatever the data plane creates the payload, from which route we need to transmit that particular packet. And which means it has to identify which particular network is having less traffic so that it can try to transmit the data. So that comes under control plane. So basically in CNA, conventional network architecture, what happened is this data plane and control plane are placed in a single shell. So here this shell consists of data plane as well as control plane. Due to which what happens, it becomes very difficult for this particular block to actually manage both of them, because traffic managing is something different and this one is entirely different. So both we need to take care. So that is what the thing that makes this particular system complex. Moreover, since we are talking about control plane here, right? Which actually, so in control plane, we actually write protocols, means nothing but algorithms, using which we try to find which particular routing network is not busy. Now, during this particular process, whatever is actually happening here, the thing is, we have different type of vendors. Like I explained earlier, we have something called Reliance Jio, we have something called as Vodafone, Idea. Now here, these will have their own protocol. They usually develop their own protocols in order to transmit these packets. So what happens, definitely since these are using different protocols, the same hardware device may not be compatible. So definitely we require a separate kind of hardware. So due to this, what happens, a central network controller who actually controls these devices and network, it becomes very difficult for him to manage these particular devices and network. That's very critical, because the protocols, there are so many protocols are there, and all these protocols need to be dumped in a single hardware, and from there it has to be transmitted, and that's very complex in nature. So we require very complex kind of hardware devices. That becomes very critical. So that's the reason this particular model did not click so much, and then we came across something called a software defined network. So these are the limitations what we already discussed, like complex network device. Yes, obviously the network device what we are going to use in order to connect to the network, that is very, very complex in nature, because it has to support many different type of protocols. So it's highly impossible for that, means it is able to support it. But the problem here is that it becomes complex. Obviously, you can understand within your laptop, if you people are using, having a 4GB of RAM, and you people want to run the latest operating system, will you be able to run it? Definitely the system will hang, because 4GB, 90% of the memory will be occupied by the operating system. Whatever the others, it's highly impossible to execute it. Okay, so that's what. So here the network device is getting complex. Same way, management overhead will be there. As I told you that we will be having network managers, it becomes difficult for them to manage these multiple devices. So every Reliance is having his own device, Vodafone is having his own device, and all this, in order to manage, in order to keep track of which one is working fine, which one is sending the signals and all, everything, it becomes difficult for the network management. Same with scalability. Scalability is something, but here multiple virtual machines are actually being generated. Now, like after the development of cloud, what happened is everything is virtual in nature. Means you people are getting the resources from the cloud, you are performing the operation, you are storing your data in cloud. But where in the data, means where in what we call in the cloud, your data is getting stored, that we don't have any information, isn't it? We know that it is stored in our cloud. Whatever the cloud you people might be using, maybe Amazon, maybe Microsoft, or maybe Google, whichever cloud you are using, you are storing the data. So where you are exactly storing, and whether it is belong to entirely to you or it belongs to others, that we don't know. That is what the thing that is represented here. Now, finally, SDN. So coming to software-defined networking here, what it's saying, this is the simplest architecture which will actually separate the control plane from the data plane. Okay, so the control plane and the data plane are placed in a separate layer, and the centralized control is given to the network controller. Means the network controller is able to control this control plane and the data plane. Okay, and he is and if we are splitting in this way, what happens? Automatically, the task will be done very easily, and whatever the network provider is there, he will, the network what we call coordinator, he will not have any problem in order to transmit the data and in order to receive the data and managing the hardware devices. Now, if you talk about here, I'll show you the architecture of it so that you people can understand. This is a simple architecture where you can see that the application layer is entirely separated from the infrastructure layer, isn't it? So earlier it was mixed. It's a combination of that two, data layer and control layer. But now the application layer, which will have network application, this is separated from the infrastructure layer. And whereas coming to here, we have something in between, we have network. So this is centralized network controller, which I was talking about. So here in this, network operating system is able to manage them separately, since both are in a separate. Now, if this particular control layer wants to interface with this particular application layer, it requires something called as northbound open API. Definitely, we require application program interfaces that we already discussed in the first unit. So this control layer, in order to communicate with the application layer, it requires something called as northbound API. And whereas coming to the south one, if you talk about here, so if you want the network communication to communicate with this infrastructure layer, we have something called southbound open API, OpenFlow. Now this is one of the standard open, what we call application program interface, which is used in order for communication purposes. Now in this diagram, you can see in the infrastructure layer, we have different network devices. These are the network devices. Now what these network devices have is simple packet forwarding hardware. So what are these network devices? Are nothing but for forwarding the packets, these are simple hardware what we are using. Means there is no overburden on this particular devices, like which route they have to transmit or which route is having less traffic. They don't have to identify. That instructions will be given by this network operator. Okay, this network controller will give the information which direction you have to send the packet. Now what is the main responsibility of this network devices is nothing but simply send the packet in that particular layer, traffic. That is what he is saying, doing in this particular scenario. That's it, nothing else. So here we have something called southbound open API, so open flow, and here we have northbound. So whenever a controller wants to communicate with them, we have a northbound API. And whenever this communicate with, whenever this operating controller want to communicate with the network devices, it will be using southbound open API, which is nothing but open flow. So these are the two what we have. Now apart from that, let's see the internal layers of your SDN. Yeah, we do have internal layers here. This is important here. See here. You can see here, there are three layers in this particular scenario. Something called as application layer, control layer, and infrastructure layer. If you talk about infrastructure layer, this will consist of network devices. I think it is already represented here. See, control layer will consist of SDN controller. Now, this is the one which actually gives information related to which path or the which route has to be selected to transmit the packet. Then the network devices will transmit that particular packet through that particular network. And whereas coming to SDN applications, this comes under application. So whatever the application we usually create, okay, those all will be coming under this SDN application. Now, in between, we already discussed in the previous slide, these are the layers. So here we have something called programmable open API, which is a northbound interface. And in between SDN controller network device, we have southbound interface. That is nothing but we are going to use something called as OpenFlow. Okay, so controller and the data plane. So here, the, in this, the control plane and the data plane are in a separate, these have been separated. Control plane will be somewhere else, data plane will be somewhere else. This controller will manage these two. So it becomes easy for them to understand or easy for them to configure anything. any kind of devices, and based on that transmit the data. So this is the layers what we have in your software defined networking layer. So here the key elements what we do have here is the centralized network controller. That is nothing but in the previous diagram what you have seen as the SDN controller in the center. Okay, let me show you. So it's better if I show you. So first one, what he is saying, centralized control. This is what he's talking about. This one, SDN controller. This is what the first one he's talking about here. Okay, and remember after that we have something called open programmable open APIs, and then we have one more. So now I will show you. Yeah. So first is centralized network controller. So you have programmable open APIs, and then we have standard communication interface open source. This is southbound. This is northbound. So if you look at here, the first one, what is saying here, this actually decouples the controller and data plane. So SDN plays a very important role here. SDN controller, he is the one who actually differentiates the data plane from the control plane. Okay, and centralized network. So here the network administrator will have the opportunity to configure the network without any hesitate, because he right now don't have to manage all the different network devices. Why? Because these network devices are decoupled now. Control will have a separate device, data plane will have a separate device. So we don't have to couple and we have to perform operation. Directly administrators can perform the configuration of that particular network without any hesitation. Or else what will happen when he is configuring that particular network, he has to find out, okay, which device is using, whether this device supports that configuration or not, that headache. But now that headache is not there for the administrator. Next, we have something called as programmable open API. Now, what is this? Already we discussed. It's a northbound interface which provides communication between the SDN application and the controller. So, in order to provide that, we use a standard API interfaces using which people can directly try to communicate. After that, we have something called as southbound interface. This is what we call standard communication interface. Now, here, OpenFlow is actually provided by ONF, something called as Open Networking Foundation. They are the ones who have given a definition for this. Now, using OpenFlow, this is a standard protocol, API what we use in order to provide interface between the infrastructure layer and the SDN controller. It do have the architecture. This OpenFlow actually consists of tables. OpenFlow tables, so group tables and layers. I will show you it with the diagram. If you can see here, it actually consists of separate tables, flow tables. Apart from that, it also consists of group tables. Okay. Now, if you talk about flow tables here, these flow tables are individual pipelines. Okay. Pipeline is nothing but, you know, one-to-one communication can take place. So these flow tables will consist of some data. I will show you in the next slide. So that data will be transmitted with the help of a pipeline. Group table means multiple tables will be there, and through this multiple communications can take place. Apart from that, we also do have something called as open flow channel. And this channel is the one which communicates with SDN layer. Means this is the entire network used for communicating with something called as network devices. Like, I'll show you open flow where we are using exactly. This is the layer. Yeah, this one. We are talking about this interface here. You people might be saying this interface I'm talking about here. We have southbound interface now. Here this interface is talking, means this SDN controller, how it can communicate with network devices, means using OpenFlow. And that is what we are discussing right now. Yes. So that is what exactly we are discussing right now. So here SDN controller is there. In the bottom here, we'll be having network devices. So in order to communicate, we are using this OpenFlow application program interface. This application program interface, okay, consists of OpenFlow channel, group table, flow table. Flow table is one-to-one communication using a pipelining kind of a concept. It is transmitted. Whereas coming to OpenFlow, if you talk about, it is actually connected with controllers and it will try to transmit the data. Okay, so this is the one. Using this channel, we can communicate with the SDN controller, and from this channel, we can communicate with the network devices. Okay, so group table consists of multiple things here. So what are the multiple things we have? Well, that is not represented. So it will consist of different fields. this particular table, group table or the open table, consists of different fields, something called as MAC ID. Okay. We have something called as MAC ID. Then we have IP address, something like, I'll show you with the help of a diagram so that it becomes easy for you. I didn't represent that. So it will actually consist of a table like this, where you will be having rules. So there will be set of rules here. Then we have something called action. Followed with that, we have a status. So if you talk about rules here, so what we are transmitting using that pipeline, the flow table will have is something called a switch port. So which port you people are trying to transmit. Then we have something called MAC ID of a source from where you are transmitting. Then we have a MAC ID of your destination, because that is required. So every device will have a MAC ID. If that is not provided, then it's not possible. Then we have ETH type. Followed with that, we have VLAN. So we have VLAN ID. Then IP source. And then we have IP source. IP means the source ID of your IP. IP address of your source. Then IP address of your destination. Then we have IP port. Okay. Then we have something called as TCP. Okay. Source port. From which means the source is using which TCP port. Then TCP destination port. So these are the one which are present in your pipeline, open flow pipeline. Now after that, what are the action here means? What are the actions we can take here is forward the packets. So forward packets. Where forward the packets to the port. So which port? The destination port. Next it has something encapsulation and forward. So it will encapsulate and forward to controller. Which controller? SDN controller. So packets, whatever are there, that will be actually forwarded to the port, and from that port it is encapsulated and forwarded to the SDN network. Then finally what we have is drop packet. So we'll be dropping the packet, and then we'll send to normal processing pipeline. Send it to normal processing pipeline. Okay, so this is the way it actually works. So these are the four steps that are taken here. And we are coming to status here. Status will have something called as byte plus. So byte of the packet plus whatever the packet we are transmitting, or how particular size of it, plus whether counter. Counter is nothing but sequence number or something like that we can use in order to transmit. Now this is the diagram which is present or which has been used in this particular flow tables. You are seeing this flow tables, right? And within this, we are actually using this particular diagram. So these are the layers which are present in your flow tables. I hope it's very clear with this. Okay, next we have something called as network function virtualization. Now what is function virtualization is, it is mostly used in cloud-based platform where you people will be providing the hardware and software based on virtual ways. Okay. So definitely virtually means it is nothing but it is similar to SDN, but it's something like, you know, additional feature which is been provided here. Both SDN and NF can provide the infrastructure, okay, based upon SDN. So these are mutually beneficial, and they do not depend on each other. Means they are similar to one another, but NFV will provide virtual kind of related information, a virtual kind of infrastructure to the audience. Okay, see, this is something like cloud. The cloud, what we can do, we are storing the information in the cloud, but where in the cloud we are storing that information, we don't have any idea, isn't it? We know that we are using a Google cloud and we are storing the information, but where exactly we are storing, we don't know. That is virtual. That is what it means. So here the network function virtualization has been developed to provide a virtual kind of network. So whenever you people are transmitting any message to your friend, you people are simply sending to that respective number, isn't it? You're simply typing the number and you're typing the message, you're sending it. But within the network, how it is transmitted to your friend, you know, okay, or to the destination, we don't know. That is what comes virtual. So here, this is the network which has been used. This is the basic network used for NFV. So we are initially, we have network function functions here, with respect to your virtual functions, all this. After that, we have NFV infrastructure. So this is the one which actually provides the infrastructure. So it can be a virtual network for transmitting the data. It can be a storage for storing your information, or it can be for computation purpose. And below that, we have a virtual layer. This layer is used for prompting, means we need to store the information, right? We require some kind of networking. So that networking is provided by this particular virtual layer. So we use it for computation purpose, networking purpose, storage purpose. Apart from that, we have something called NFV management and orchestrate. This is someone who actually controls. This is something like manager. There should be someone who controls these devices, okay? So that they're properly functioning or not, taking the status and all. So that is what represented in this particular thing. So virtual network function. Now here also, we basically have key elements in this. Just a minute. Okay, so here, so VNF, what are you saying exactly here? Virtual network function. So it is, in this, we have three many different type of key elements. The first one is virtualized network function. When virtualized network function, what are you saying? It's actually a software implementation. Definitely, we require some elements which are required in order to perform that particular task. So here we have a implementation. It's a software implementation. For what we are doing it? For networking purpose, okay? So here we will be running network NFV infrastructures, okay? Next, what we have here is, so next one what we have here is NVI. So what do you mean by NVI? Is nothing but this is the infrastructure which is required in order to perform or in order to make computation of NFVI. So basically in this, what we are exactly doing, I'll tell you. So if you talk about your NFVI infrastructure, what exactly we are doing is nothing but whatever the previous diagram I have shown in that how the communication takes place for computation purpose, storing and this, we are actually using these two features, something called as VNF, that is virtual network function. So here, whatever the network functions we are providing that are virtual in nature, means we will not be able to know how that function is working, but simply we are representing it. Okay, so here that is what is using it. Now, NVI infrastructure is nothing but it is used for computation, network and storage. So whatever the data we want to store it, for that resources, whatever we are using, in order to manage that, we are using NVI infrastructure. But whereas coming to virtual network function, this is actually used for communicating, means the network, how to communicate, that is what, how can I explain you? Okay, fine. Let us suppose we have a source and we have a destination. Okay, now from the source, you people are transmitting packets like this. So here, it will be stored somewhere, right? So here somewhere it will be stored. So here this networking, in order to control how the packets are routed and networked, we are using this. But whereas coming to infrastructure, this is used for storing the data here, storing it, computing it, and performing some other kind of information that comes under here. Now coming to this particular NFV management, This is mainly related to something called as life cycle management of physical and software resources. Means this is only used for upgradation. Means if you want to configure anything, if you want to update anything, for that purpose we use this NFC management. So here basically what happens here is we will be upgrading the information, like, you know, new software comes up, we need to update the version. So those all will be taken care by this NFC management. Okay, that is what he's saying. So here he's saying, talking about life cycle management is nothing but it will be taken in a format of a process. Like it will have, it is a kind of a life cycle. So initially we have created a new app, we are installing in it. Then after some time many users are using. If there are new version, new updates are there, that updates we are doing it here and again we are transmitting. So this is the way the whole process actually takes place. Okay. So this is what the whole it has been explained in this particular time. The NFV use cases. So here we have different use cases that are basically explained here. This is a diagram related to that. So NFV can be used for home networks, for home automation and all. So how, till now, whatever the diagrams we have seen, how that can be used in order to get connected to your home automation purpose, that is what explained here in this particular diagram. If you look at, this is a home network, what we have a mobile, so we have internal phone, we have a TV here, laptops, lights, all this we are connecting with the help of a device. Okay, this is a single board computers, whatever thing computers he's talking about. Now all these are connected to this particular router. That is the router which will be accessing point. We are discussing about IoT layers, right? In IoT layer, we discussed about network device. So this is a network device. Now this network device is actually connected to all the devices which are present in our home. From here, it is actually connected to your public network. So this is what we have. And within this, we have virtualized home gateway. Now this virtualized home gateway, what we are seeing here, NFV infrastructure will be present within this. This is a cloud. This is the cloud what we are accessing. Now within this we have NFV infrastructure. The infrastructure is used for what? Computation purpose, computing, storing, and what else? We have one more now, computing, storing, and something called as manipulation, something like that. So all these three features are supported by this particular, okay, NFV infrastructure, analysis purpose. So here, these cloud will be connected. You people can access this particular cloud either using internet, you can use some other kind of network, or VoIP. VoIP is nothing but this is something like your, we have Reliance Jio, right? We, many of you are using Reliance network. So that comes under VoIP. Internet is nothing but if service provider is providing you the internet connection, like BSNL, we have UTele. So those all comes under internet. So in the, we have IPTV. This is one of the family member of your internet connections only, using which you people can try to connect to this particular device. Now whatever the data you people are performing here, all the data can be stored in this using NFV architecture. And here the gateway is provided. We already discussed about gateway in SDN. So similarly, this also has a gateway using which it actually communicates. So this is the way it is going to perform. This is the whole scenario. So whenever you're switching on the lights, okay, from your, before entering in your room, how you can do it means you are connected with this particular cloud. You will send the signals to the cloud with the help of your smartphone. From the chat, it will be transmitted to the router which is present, access point, which is present in your home. From here, it will automatically try to turn on your lights. Okay, so this is the way it actually works. So this is all related to your NFV also. Network function virtualization. It's everything is virtualized. Fine, so this is, with this we actually completed the first part of the unit 2. So in the next session, we'll be discussing about the next part. So that is nothing but it's related to how, what are the different protocols we use in that, SMTP and all, what are the drawbacks we have in SMTP protocols and some other similar kind of protocols. Fine, for today's session, this much only we are having. Thank you.